The cloud makes available a set of computing resources as needed by the client, such as servers, storage, or ready-to-use applications. When we say a service is in the cloud, it means that the means of production to provide this service are managed and hosted by the cloud service provider, for example, AWS, Microsoft Azure, or Google Cloud. There are several types of usage models based on the technical layer they offer, each playing a specific role. Let's explain these usage models with an example. Matthew is a young chef who opened a business to provide services for all your chocolate chip cookie cravings. Matthew offers a range of services to meet all your needs. In the first model called Ingredients as a Service, Matthew supplies clients with all the necessary ingredients on demand. Note that the responsibilities of each party are summarized in the left diagram. The client's actions are in black, and Matthew's are in orange. Here, he takes care of providing all the necessary ingredients to make the dough. This means the client no longer needs to go shopping because Matthew takes care of it and delivers the ingredients to the clients, regardless of the quantity requested, whether it's ingredients for 10 cookies or 1,000 cookies. However, the client needs to have an oven to bake these ingredients into cookies, find a table to eat them, and beverages to accompany the cookies. This model is intended for cooking enthusiasts as it allows clients to focus on cooking delicious homemade cookies without worrying about shopping for ingredients. The second model is Cookie as a Service, offering ready-to-eat chocolate chip cookies on demand to clients. Compared to the ingredient as a service model, here, in addition to shopping, Matthew also takes care of baking the cookies with the steps of putting them in the oven. Here, the client just needs to find a place to eat the cookies and beverages to accompany them, such as a glass of milk. This offer is intended for gourmet clients who enjoy indulging in cookies without having to make them. Finally, the last service is Experience as a Service, where Matthew offers a real culinary experience. Here, the client doesn't need to do anything since Matthew will take care of everything, procuring the ingredients, cooking them, and offering a table in a pleasant setting. Matthew will also propose gourmet drinks to enhance the taste of the cookies, for example, with a cappuccino or a milkshake. Here, the target clients are people who want to experience a culinary adventure without having to do anything but enjoy. Matthew offers three service models based on the client's needs, which, as we've seen, vary for each model. Well, for the cloud, it's the same. There are different cloud service models based on the client's needs for computing resources. Let's first look at the three models of the traditional approach. Infrastructure as a service corresponds to the infrastructure part of the cloud. Logically, the name suggests that it provides instances, storage, and network connection. Instead of buying the hardware, clients pay for on-demand infrastructure services. The strength of infrastructure as a service is to offer highly scalable infrastructure resources, meaning they can be adjusted on demand according to the user's needs. The client takes care of installing, configuring, and updating the OS, middlewares, and applications. The rest is managed by the cloud provider. The target audience is IT operators. Now, let's move on to platform as a service. Like infrastructure as a service, it also involves technical infrastructure layers. But platform as a service additionally offers clients a set of integrated tools for developing applications, such as frameworks, compilers, code editors, file managers, etc. It also provides middleware instances like a web server, an application server, or a database management system. This model allows clients to focus on application development. Developers are the target audience. Then we have software as a service. The goal is to provide ready-to-use applications running on the cloud provider's infrastructure. These applications are accessible to clients via a browser. The advantage for the client is never having to worry about updating the application or the underlying infrastructure, since everything is managed and hosted by the cloud provider. For the client, it's just about using the application via a web interface. End users are the target audience. Now, let's talk about two new cloud models that are very trendy. The first model is Container as a Service. The specificity of this service is container technology, and Docker is the most popular containerization technology. Containers are isolated and separated execution environments at the operating system level. Container as a Services allows clients to deploy and manage containers throughout their life cycle. This mainly includes starting and stopping containers, grouping them into clusters, scaling containers, load balancing, automated updates, and failover procedures. Now, let's see the difference between Platform as a Service and Container as a Service, because there is often confusion between the two. Platform as a Service simplifies the application development process. Its goal is to allow deploying an application without needing to worry about the infrastructure required to do so. On the other hand, Container as a Service does not include development tools. Container as a Service only provides tools to deploy and manage containers and the underlying infrastructure. However, your application should be developed separately. Now let's move on to Function as a Service. In this model, the developer is responsible for coding functions. A function can be triggered by events, for example, when it is called by an HTTP request. This request triggers the code execution and can query a database, for example. Once the action is completed, the process ends. Each function has a single purpose. In this case, the developer only needs to provide their code for one or more functions, and everything else is taken care of by the cloud service provider. Function as a service can be used for scheduled tasks, for example, to run a specific piece of code at a scheduled date or frequency. It can also be used for building automated workflows with a set of functions that can call each other and trigger actions with other cloud services. That's why it is often associated with serverless offerings like AWS Lambda or Azure Functions. Indeed, serverless services are only active when the function is being used, allowing the same computing resources to be allocated elsewhere when the server is shut down. Finally, let's conclude this topic with the difference between Function as a Service and Platform as a Service, because there is also confusion between the two. The goal of Platform as a Service is to simplify the development of applications, and when an application is deployed on Platform as a Service, the application continuously runs on servers. On the other hand, with Function as a Service, you have the ability to trigger a single function or part of the application only when needed. This means that functions do not run until they are solicited. It's the end of this video. If this video helped you, you can support me by subscribing and sharing it. See you in the next video. Goodbye.